2013 film American Hustle follows the life of con man Irving Rosenfeld during the bustling 1970s. Irving and his mistress, Sidney Prosser, are busted for their crimes and are forced to help FBI agent Richie DeMaso take down some of New Jersey's leading politicians, including the mayor of Camden, Carmine Polito. Irving quickly finds himself being launched into a world of political corruption, along with threats from the mafia and his meddling wife, Rosalind, who could bring down the so-called abscam operation at any moment. The character Irving Rosenfeld represents real-life con man Mel Weinberg. Richie DeMaso represents FBI agent Anthony Amoroso. Carmine Polito represents Mayor of Camden Angelo Arricchetti. Rosalind Rosenfeld represents Mel's troubled wife Marie Weinberg. And Sidney Prosser represents Mel's longtime mistress Evelyn Knight.
I took down some very big guys, some of whom they were just doing business as usual, helping their communities or their states. But some of them knew they had larceny in their blood, and they even admitted it. But in all, it was 6 congressmen, 1 United States senator, and my friend Carmine Polito.
As depicted in the movie, Mel Weinberg did actually contribute to the abscam operation's successful conviction of 6 congressmen, 1 senator, and Camden's mayor on charges of bribery. American Hustle's choices of wardrobe and music are authentic to the 1970s. Most people had elaborate hairstyles, such as the mayor's pompadour. Men often wore 3-piece suits, and women began wearing fur coats. Disco music and dance became extremely popular during this decade. Paul McCartney's song for the James Bond film, Live and Let Die, became a hit in the 70s.
This ever-changing world in which we live in makes you give in a cry. Say, live and let die. Live and let die.
In the movie, Irving's mistress and accomplice, Sidney, plays a huge part in his scams. After being caught by the FBI for impersonating a British woman with royal banking connections, Sidney is forced to participate in an abscam with Irving. In reality, Sidney's inspiration, Evelyn Knight, was never even involved in the abscam operation. Evelyn, who is actually British, did help Mel Weinberg in a previous con and almost got arrested, but Mel affirms that Evelyn had no part in the abscam.
We gave the $2 million back, so Carmine got the reduced sentence. 18 months. The loss of his friendship would haunt me for the rest of my life. Sid and I, we moved in together. Rosalind.
The car is a little dinged up. I'm a little stiff, but whatever. I don't want to talk about it.
She would always be interesting.
Bye for now. I'll see you next weekend.
The ending of American Hustle is completely fabricated. Mel did not swindle the FBI and Agent Amoroso in order to reduce the mayor's sentence like Irving did, and Mel and Marie Weinberg did not peacefully part ways as Irving and Rosalind did. Marie did not have a boyfriend in the mafia that she left Mel for. Sadly, Marie was unable to deal with the failed state of her marriage and hung herself on January 28, 1982. American Hustle's storyline was adapted from the historical abscam operation. However, it did frequently stray from the historical facts of the event, and therefore the film must be categorized as fiction. The movie did accurately portray some of the major points of abscam, but other aspects of the operation were dramatized by the filmmakers or completely left out of the film. American Hustle provides a good look into the political corruption of the 1970s, yet it should not be regarded as a source of historical fact.